Maxwell, Koshi, Besah, Gbormittah. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labor, for their deeds will follow them. Revelation 14:13. A brief biography of the late Dumega Maxwell, Koshi, Besah, Gbormittah. God saw you got tired when a cure was not to be. So he whispered, come to me. A golden heart has stopped beating. Hard-working hands put to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. It takes only the best. Amen.
Amen.
Maxwell Koshi Besah Gbormittah was born at Anyakoko on 18 February 1940. To Nani Gbormittah and Wosipo Jikunu, both of blessed memory. He was baptized in his infancy at Yipi Rima Church. Anyako. He was the second in line with his parents. Koshi Besah started his education at Evangelical Presbyterian Bremer Mission Primary School in 1950 and continued to AA Fia Middle School at Anyako Kota. Some of his classmates were Kujo Dovlo, Godson Kosiche Anaglate, Rubin Koshi Motoji, Yaoka Jikunu, Julius Kusobo, Mercy Dute, Margaret Achu, just to mention a few. He finally completed middle school in 1957. After school, Maxwell alias Pizzi left for Accra for greener pastures. He was employed by UTC Stores, where he worked for a few years before he resigned and traveled by ship to Germany. There he worked briefly and finally left for London. In the UK, he was employed by the Thorns Company and others. He finally set up his own business such as Dual Star Limited and Mark Star Limited. He then became a renowned shipping agent. He lived in the UK for 40 years. Koshi was a philanthropist and royal. Owing to this, he was selected, elected, and installed as Dumega for Anyakokun Township. He held this position until his untimely death on 3rd September 2021. In fact, a golden heart has stopped beating. Hard-working hands have been put to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. It takes the best. I pray that the Almighty God gives you everlasting rest. He left behind his wife, Mrs. Vera Sichofa Gbormittah, Nisichofa Vera Dikunu, and the children, namely Alec Blim Shelter, Koblan, Adam McCaffrey, Ewenam, Louis Achu, Leslie Eche, and four grandchildren. Fare thee well till we meet again.
Tribute from the wife, then the children, Eli Gbormittah, them and Makafwi, Ralph Gawu, then Lovia UK, H UK, and then France.
I just wanted to update the program. Before non-relatives give their tributes, we would have this in the following order: the wife, children, grandchildren, and then KMUK, Novia, and Co. Thank you. So can you all line up, as Reverend has said, so that we can go through the program swiftly? Thank you. Thank you.
it go. On my finger, you brought love like I've never known. You gave life to our children and to me a reason to go on. You're my bread when I'm hungry. You're my shelter from troubled winds. You're my anchor in life's ocean. But most of all, you're my best friend.
When the day of toil is done, when the race of life is run, Father, grant their wearied one rest forevermore. Composed by C.C. Scofield, 1839 to 1904. Maxie, as I affectionately called you, I don't really know where and how to start our love story. But I can, with all honesty, pride, boldness, call you my husband and the father of our twins, Achu and Eche, and their older siblings, big brother Ellie, Adam, Makafui, and Yvette. We had our good and trying moments, which embodied the package of married life. You were very caring and supportive when we were blessed with necessary means. Achu and Eche always cherish the times they spent together with you when we visited you in London and anytime you came around. You lavished them with so much love through the presents you brought to them and the quality of time spent together. The journey of life has its ups and downs. We had good laughs and shared in each other's pain. Maxie, we all became worried when you began to have health challenges, which took you in and out of hospital for some time and eventually leading to you being admitted at Royal Free Hospital in London. I will not forget when my brother Malco and I visited you several times at the hospital in London. As expected of a dutiful wife, I was helpless not to be able to be by your side as much as I would love to. But I am very grateful you had wonderful, caring people around you all the time, who gave you the needed love and care until your demise. Maxie, as you were aware, I had my traveling arrangements in place to visit you when COVID-19 set in, making me feel so devastated. At this point, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Dr. Togobu and the wife, Ralph and Cecilia, Godfrey and Pat, Robert and all others, and my cousin Sister Maggie, who devoted their precious time to attend to you in various ways. Sister Maggie, thank you very much. May God richly bless all of you for the love you've showed my husband. Maxie, you lost your capacity and was moved into a care home where you continue to be cared for and well supported. To the care home Fairview Care Home, the manager Sonil and the team, thank you very much for the wonderful care you gave my husband. Maxi, I've always been updated on the state of health. Myself, Yvette, and the boys had wished you had come to Ghana, where we could show our love and care, but our desires did not materialize. Meeting Ellie was one of the happiest days in my life. A fair photocopy of you with all the features. We just clicked from day one, and ever since, he has been my eldest son. I will forever keep in mind that moment when Sister Maggie arranged a video conference call, which your eldest son Ellie, who was in Ghana at the time, my brother Malco, the twins, Achu Eneche, and few family friends. We all saw the excitement on your face when you were addressed with your nickname, that is Tochi Tobara, Enua Vemowa Mao, Nadopo Nagaruvo, Kekau, and etc. Upon seeing Ellie in the video call, you jokingly said, "Hey, what are you doing in my wife's house?" And we all laughed together and responded, "Kekau." And then you smiled. This fond memory will be with me forever. None of us knew that was going to be our last time seeing and talking with you, since you could bounce back to life, singing and cheerful. Maxi, may the good Lord grant you peaceful rest. Myself, Yvette, and the boys bid you farewell. Hedenye na jijolenti fafama. Vera, sichope bomita ni jikunu. Amen.
You are the
We'll continue. It's our tradition that when our chiefs join us, we welcome them formally to the event before continuing. We're now going to hear the tribute from the children and then the grandchildren.
Thank you. Tribute from Eli Bomita, our oldest brother. Your part is the lot of all mankind. The world is a scene of constant leave-taking, and the hands that grasp in cordial greetings today are doomed ere long to unite for the last time, when the quivering lips pronounce the words farewell. And this is a poem by R.M. Valentine, a tribute. If I were to choose between being closer to you earlier and further apart from you before your dismay, and being part from you in our earlier years, but being closer to you before your dismay, I would choose the latter. I have come to love and cherish you as my father. Though we might not have had this lovely relationship earlier, Kiya Kawo, as we affectionately called you, it's only the agony of partaking do we look into the depth of love. Words cannot express the joy I felt each time I visited you in the care home. We bonded and became closer than ever. This bond deepened furthermore when I visited Ghana and met with my stepmother, Auntie Vera. It was my happiest holiday in Ghana. It was so much fun when we had that video call courtesy Sister Maggie. When you saw us together, you asked, "What are you doing in my wife's house?" And we all responded, "Kaya Kao," not knowing that was to be the last live conversation we were to have, that I would come back to London and not be able to visit you again. Thank you very much, Sister Maggie, for your instrumentality in this union. Kaya Kao, may the good Lord grant you a peaceful rest till we meet again. The next tribute is from Edem and McCarthy Bonja, myself and my youngest. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1 to 8, there's time for everything. Everyone here will have their own special memories of my dad, either as a husband, a father, a brother, a grandfather, or Dumega. A man of principle, strong-willed, opinionated, full of smiles and the joy of every party. Even though we had our differences, we wish to have spent more time with you. You will always be in our thoughts and prayer. Rest in peace, Daddy. We will never forget you and we'll love you forever.
A tribute on behalf of the grandchildren.
a tribute on behalf of myself, Ewenam, and Salam to our grandfather. A man as humble and loving as Grandpa will always be remembered by those who knew him and loved him. Although we will miss him, his smile, his love, his manner, we take consolation in the good feelings of our memories. We remember when Grandpa would always visit us. We were very excited to see him with a bag full of goodies. We would sit on his lap and open the bag and enjoy. He used to bring us Juicy Fruit chewing gum, and we used to fight over them. It was so much fun to be around. He loved to laugh and to have fun, and we just adored him. Grandpa always said that his grandchildren kept him young at heart. That made us feel good inside. We can see that our father got his loving spirit from Grandpa. He was a great teacher to have, not only for us, but also for everybody. He was selfless and kind. He loved being a parent and grandparent. It was his calling in life. Grandpa, we will always miss you, but we have so many memories to hang on to. You were a role model and a friend. Your guidance and love will carry us through to the end of our days. We love you, Grandpa.
Hello. This is a tribute to Dumega, Maxwell, Koshi, Mensan, Gbormittah, on behalf of AGK. The first time we met was at an association. The Association of Ex-Servicemen and Ghanaian Men, Women, UK fundraiser, when he came with Mr. and Mrs. Raphael Gaul and then Mrs. Cecilia Gaul. He was very kind and generous. After the event, we interacted and then fell in love with him. The whole association was very happy. He became a member and later was appointed the very first life patron of the association. I can recollect the year he came to the fundraising at our meeting place at Holloway. He used to attend our meetings and then celebrations of the year, parties, and several events. He felt ill around 2016, and the association always checked on him and visited him until his demise on the 2nd of September 2021. So far, these are the contributions to assist you in preparation of the tribute. Thank you very much.
If I may call upon Novia UK to I'm quite done in family.
I see. Reverend Hedidor, Reverend Fumi, family and friends. These are very sad times for the Gbormittah family. We all know that. But it is sad times for a lot of other people, not least Nobiha. Nobiha is an Navy association in the UK, as many of you will know. And we are here in our mourning cloth. Nobiha will be 40 years old next year. And from all those who have stayed with the association this long, I hear that Mr. Gbormittah has been closely associated with this organization. As the tributes I will read, will show. Tribute to Dumega Maxwell Gbormittah. The very close association between Nobiha UK and the late Dumega Maxwell Gbormittah began in 1996. That was the year Nobiha initiated the celebration of Obetoto as an annual fundraising festival to support worthwhile projects in Ghana, especially in the Volta region. Nobiha subsequently invited the late Togbi Tenge Jokotoglibi VI, paramount chief of Anyako and the custodian of the Obetoto rites at the time, to travel to London to officially inaugurate the festival. Nobiha made the various travel arrangements necessary to enable Togbi to travel to the UK, but faced a major problem. Where and how do we provide accommodation befitting a paramount chief that Togbi Libi was? To our great relief, the late Dumega Gbormittah offered to be the host for Togbi on Nobiha's behalf for the entire duration of Togbi's stay in the UK. Although not a registered member of the organization, Dumega made his residence available for Togbi's lodging and for the many meetings that Togbi would have with Nobiha and other guests. The inauguration of Nobiha's first Obetoto festival was a huge success, and we have always acknowledged the contribution of Dumega to that success. One of Nobiha's charity projects was collecting books of academic subjects from schools in and around London for distribution to secondary schools in the Volta region. Nobiha approached Dumega Gbormittah for the help in shipping the books to Ghana. It is on our records that for the many years that the project lasted, Dumega willingly and benevolently supported the Nobiha project through his freight company, and large volumes of books were successfully shipped to Ghana for the benefit of many needy schools. Dumega extended his generosity to Nobiha also in his patronage of our fundraising functions, at which he was always a prominent donor. These initiatives ultimately funded Nobiha's medical equipment and material supplies to health clinics, as well as scholarships for some underprivileged students in the Volta region. Nobiha UK believes that all these indirect beneficiaries of Dumega's benevolence would like to join Nobiha UK in publicly expressing our gratitude to the memory of Dumega and to offer our heartfelt condolences to his entire family. Dumega Maxwell Gbormittah, you have sadly left us, but your goodwill will remain indelible in our memories. For and on behalf of the directors and members of Nobiha UK. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. With that background, I will now invite
Reverend to continue with. We welcome. I think it's important that we complete the communical process, and we will. There is a lot to be said about Mr. Gbormittah, late Dumega Gbormittah, and we will do justice to him. Reverend, tell us your opinion.
We continue with the third hymn on page 19. God be with you till we meet again. Consoles us are the words from the scriptures. So we come to our Bible readings. They are printed from page 23.
chapter 3, from verse 1 to 8 and 11. A time for everything. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search, and a time to give up. A time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to mend. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Amen. Amen.
Our second reading will be taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1 to 10. Awaiting the new body. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an external house in heaven, not built by human hands. Meanwhile, we groan, longing to be clothed instead with our heavenly dwelling. Because when we are clothed, we will not be found naked. For while we are in this tent, we groan and we are burdened, because we do not wish to be unclothed, but be clothed instead with our heavenly dwelling, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. Now the Lord who has fashioned us for this very purpose is God, who has given us the Spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. Therefore, we are always confident, and we know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we live by faith, but not by sight. We are confident, I say, and will prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So we make it our goal to please Him, whether we are home in the body or away from it. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each of us may receive what is due for us. For the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. Amen.
The third Bible reading is taken from John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6 and 27, New International Version. Jesus comforts his disciples. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Jesus, the way to the Father. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Peace I leave with you.
my father, peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid. May God bless us, the reading of the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
On this solemn occasion, which demands the closest survey by each one of us here present this night, I am privileged to address you. This, to some of us, is a sad moment, when all of us have met together around the mortal remains of our dear departed, Dumega, Maxwell, Koshi, Besah, Gbormittah, whose memory we cherish. Indeed, it is sad, because we cannot see Dumega, Pezi, Toti, Maxi, and I picked up another one, Pierre-Carl. We cannot see him physically again. He has flown out of the earthly vessel which encased him and is gone to where the weary is at rest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Friends, the frail thread which joins Dumega's material body together with his immaterial soul is snapped. So we are sure to be sad. But the writer of the book of Ecclesiastes lays down this great fact in chapter 3, which we just had read a short while ago, that there is a time for everything, a season for every activity under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die. All of us gathered here know that our physical lives will one day end. But we do not know when that end will come for us or for any of our loved ones, or which means it will come by. It could happen in an instant through an accident or health crisis. Despite our knowledge of this, one of the most devastating sorrows of life is the loss of a loved one. In our case this night, a dad, a husband, a friend, a colleague, a group member. When death, the final close of life's eventual history, occurs in whichever manner or time or age, it is always hard for us to deal with, isn't it? The occurrence is one that casts a curtain of gloom over the sunshine of our lives. By this, we are reminded that we are but human and must, in the order of things, be soon called from the present scene of action to that state which is different from the present one. These are hard experiences, friends, in our lives, which are simply a part of what it means to be finite creatures. It is a part of our creaturely existence that in life there is decay as well as growth. There is age as well as being a child, a kiddie, a youth, a young adult. There is loss as well as gain, pain as well as pleasure, sickness as well as health, then, of course, death as well as birth. We Christians know, and our doctrine teaches us, that in the midst of life, we are in death. Creaturely life, at its best, is fragile and temporary. This is why we should never forget that life is the only period which God has given us to labor in. Work while it is day. The night comes when no person can see and work. Those are impressive words that came from the lips of our Lord and Savior and are worth noting at this funeral. Work while it is day. The night comes when no person can see and work. They are enough to teach us, those living, the necessity of the right use of our privileges and our opportunities. We heard from Paul in the reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Part of it says, "For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not made, not built by human hands. So we make it our goal to please Him, whether we are at home in the body or away from it. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each of us may receive what is due us for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad." Am I speaking to somebody? We all receive letters, don't we, from time to time. As we ponder or reflect on the awful subject, death, the final close of life's eventful history, shall we impress ourselves with the spiritual lessons we can learn from letters that we receive or those that we write? As soon as one decides to write a letter, one must have gotten, apart from the pen and paper, an envelope as well as a stamp. These days they made it even easier for us. You must have money to purchase a stamp or take it to the post office and be able to pay for the postage. It is then that we proceed to write to whoever we aim at. On finishing, we put the written letter in an envelope and drop it in the post box, where the postmaster in this country, Royal Mail people, caters for the letter, so it gets going. The affixed stamp is stamped and thus rendered unfit for any other fellow's use. The envelope, together with the stamp, takes the letter to its recipient, who, glad for being written to, proceeds straight away to open the envelope. These days, not all the letters we receive we like to open. They used to come in brown envelopes.
They've changed the style now to white, so that we can open them. But you know what they contain. But it is not that type of letter I'm talking about, all right? We may take the envelope, tear it up, cut it, or carefully open to get what is in it. The bearer, that is the envelope, with the affixed stamp is dropped into a dustbin after being squeezed or, these days, shredded, because you don't want the address to be seen and used by somebody else. And there ends its journey. As for the letter, a suitable time and place are secured. You read over it again, you file it away, you keep it safe, you want to refer to it. Fellow mothers, saying bye-bye to Dumega, this is exactly what we are. A letter sent to the world by God and closed in this body, the envelope. And here on earth, in this world, we add our own stamp of decoration and cherish our body. We give our body all the necessary postages, traveling far and near, achieving much or less in the social, economic, educational, and cultural trends of this world. We get so bent on these that we forget that the only thing of value in us is the soul. Shall I say that again? The only thing of value in us is not this body, not this outer one, but the soul inside us. By and large, we get into the hands of the receiver, death, who makes void all our prestige, our ranks, our files, by dropping us into the dustbin of the body, the grave. This he does by tearing our bodies in accident, in disasters, opening them up carefully through sickness or some other means to expose the letters we have written in our soul. The letter passes this on into the hands of the owner of the letter, and this owner is God, who goes on to find what type of message we have. Paul again tells us, none of us lives for himself only, and none of us dies for himself only. So, friend, you might have been engaged in all types of events that make life apparently promising. But when you are faced with the question of eternity, you would want time, probably, to go back to the world to retrace your journey. And then you will remember that the postage stamp is already rendered void and is out of use for any return journey. In other words, work while it is day. Night comes. This is the time as we hear and celebrate and send off Dumega for all that is done. You need to think about your own soul, the letter you are writing or you have written, or the comments people will say about you, because your postage stamp will be, nobody will use it anymore at all. It is rendered void. The time will surely come when the Lord, the righteous judge, will set his face against you, read your letter, and remember Paul's writing in the 2 Corinthians that we read again. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each of us may receive what is due us for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. You will then realize the value of what life you have lived. It may be too late then to rewrite or change the message. What profit does it give us to continue decorating our body, the envelope, with all care? Some of you might remember a TV program, Hyacinth. When Hyacinth wants to post a letter, he even put a ruler before he put a stamp We want to get it straight. We have been doing those sort of things for ourselves, but we are forgetting that we need to check our souls as we live. How to be part of Noviga, how to be part of HUK, how to be part of your family, how to be part of where you work and be good. We forgot sometimes. As you listen, and before your written letter, your soul gets into the Lord's hands, who is the ultimate owner. Why don't you give your heart, your all, to Christ, who says, I will never turn anyone who comes to me. That is why Jesus, in the third reading from John, we have tonight, says, there are many dwelling places in my Father's house. I go to prepare a place for you. I will take you to be with me. Dumega, Wesi, Maxi is gone. And if the letter is written, it fits all that we are trying to say, it's going to take the place Jesus has promised in the Father's house. Then there's no teaching, matashing, chonen manoin, malio. All reserve no, what that you know. The valley, la land, the place is just there for you. The letter writing now takes you there, and then you just go and sit. Nobody will, they will not shift whoever you are. No. Also, for Dzandu-Hedidor, can we get there? Remember that God sent his Son, Jesus Christ, into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Ours on this earth is sublunary rehabilitation. Our stay, sister, our stay, brother, on this earth is limited and uncertain. That is why Dumega is now gone, even at the age of 81. Dumega has written his letter. It is being read by God. Probably he's even already finished reading it. What type of letter are you writing? What is your message that the Lord, the Director Judge, will read about you? Let us thank God for giving Dumega Maxwell a Koshi Besah to us. For everything Dumega achieved by God's grace during his life, for the gracefulness, for the warmth, for the tenderness he embodied. Let us praise God that for Dumega, all suffering and sorrow are ended, death itself is past, and he lives forever in God's love and care. That is where you and I would also want to go and live, in God's love and care. And let us give thanks for what he was to those who knew him and had relationship with him. Let us give thanks that he was such a person that we are moved to grief and sorrow by his loss. Remember, from his funeral, you are a letter sent to the world by God and closed in the body you have on. What are you writing? What is your message to the Lord, the righteous, that will read?
The late Maxwell Gbormittah and Pat, Miss Pat Amadepe, used to sing together and dance together. And as part of that tapestry we are trying to create this evening, can I invite Pat, Miss Amadepe, to come and sing the song you sang with the late Mr. Gbormittah?
Uncle Maxwell, when HUK celebrated Uncle Maxwell's 75th birthday for him, it was the most wonderful, awesome day he ever had. And I remember after the party, I went to him and he said, I'll say this in a way, oh, wanuaganuala, wotu chigbana, enya, tochitubala, wotu chigbana, oh, I see there, Madakuku, the Matoga Daddy, now, Twins Raduna, Magabu. It means they celebrated my birthday. They made me enjoy. And ever since I visit him, he always, we sing this song and we dance. And it's one of Toby. Akbalu, Johanna Dohotorachi, yo yi bajina me. I'm a pupo yi bablaka. I'm a mama no bo wanuna. Ina mama no bo wanuna. And the two of us, we dance. And he said that the Akbalu music, it goes like Godifufu Mado Kliya Kliya. Then I said, oh, you see, that's how it sounds. Godifufu Mado Kliya Kliya. And the two of us, anytime we visit, we sing, this song, we dance. And Madasi Patna is gone.
Thank you very much. And just before Reverend continues, there were one or two people mentioned in some of the tributes earlier, and they want to place on record a two-minute tribute in memory of the late Dumega, Gbormittah. First of all, Mr. Gawu, followed by Dr. Togobo.
A tribute from me, Mr. Raphael Gawu, to the late Dumega Maxwell Koshi, Besah Gbormittah. I happened to meet Dumega Maxwell, Koshi Besah Gbormittah, in the year 1989 at his shop called Kitamini Market in Bridgegrove, North London. This was after a call from one Mr. Godwin Anagbo, who arrived from Ghana on a business trip. On that fateful day, myself, Godfrey Togobo, and one Lemuntako met with Mr. Gbormittah for the first time. He took us to his home at Edmonton with Mr. Nabo to meet with the then wife, Anna. In his home at Edmonton, Mr. Gbormittah and the wife entertained us that evening till late. I follow up a few days later. We thank him for the reception. From here, we form a relationship and started visiting each other. Apart from his shop, he also ran a shipping company called Dewstar Shipping Services at Unit 2, 26 Osman Road, Shoreditch, London.
we continue our relationships, and he grew from strength to strength. I remember December 2008, when he was going away on holidays to Ghana. He surprisingly gave me his bank card and asked me to collect rents from his tenants and pay into his account and pay the bills. I was surprised and I asked him, "Are you sure what you're doing?" He said, "Of course. That's why I'm asking you to do it." And I took this as an honor. I continued doing this until he gave that flat up. Few years later, I introduced him to an association of Ghanaian Air Service men and women, UK. That was 2008. Mr. Gbormittah was immediately made the first and last patron of the association until 2017, when his health started failing him. He remained a patron until death. On weekends, we visit each other and share meals together, prepared by my wife, Cecilia. My wife Cecilia and I continue to regularly visit him home for meals until his health. Mr. Gbormittah loves Guinness and was nicknamed a Chiwo, means black water. In my home, there's a special chair that when he comes in, no one goes there. That's his seat. Before he takes his seat, he said, "Ralph, Chiwo, means Guinness." His Guinness, I quickly give it to him. Mind you, our relationship were not always smooth without hiccups. We do fall out and get back on. He is someone who easily forgives. He's generous and kind in many ways. A very soft-hearted man I have ever come across. I've also become his personal secretary, advisor, a bodyguard. Mr. Gbormittah loves football and supported Arsenal and knows every player by name. At the end of any match that Arsenal loses, Mr. Dumega will never eat, neither attend to any phone calls. And if you get to his home, his TV channel is always on sports channel. Same as his radio. You dare not change any of these channels. He loves music and dancing and entertaining. Mr. Gbormittah supports charities and collect books for Novia and ship it to Ghana through Mr. De La Yvonne. During his later days, he was not left alone. He received support from Dr. Togobo, Godfred Togobo, Margaret Akwaku, Robert Japasu, Mr. Alex Kodonu, myself, and my family, and many others. Mr. Maxwell Bomisa will be really missed. Patemie, Najoni Chiba Fama, Koshi Tobara, and Mofa Womo, Mulo Bucho, Agadofu. Don't be greedy. You can't be a hunchback and also have a decent, a big, decent. I'm just here. How do you sleep? So please choose one. and live one. Thank you.
It's a small tribute to Maxwell, Gbormittah. In life, you work and you do things only. If in life you do things only for yourself, when you die, you take them with you. But if you do it for others, it becomes your legacy. I've known Maxwell since the 70s in London, and we have been very good friends since. Making contributions was very close to Dumega's life. In the 70s and 80s, I used to invite him to a desirable boy's dinner dance fundraiser, and he was very generous in his givings, and he offered many occasions to send our items free to a desired college for us, and which were very, very appreciated. I remember the late, who was a good friend, told me how Maxwell, through his generosity, has saved him from a tricky situation in Anyago. Dumega, you have done well. We will not forget you. You rest in peace.
Thank you. Thank you for your indulgence. I mean, there are lots of people who want to say something about their knowledge and experience of Dumega Gbormittah, but time is always against us. Time is always against us. And I have no doubt that we will all meet again in the Thanksgiving ceremony, where we will pay our respect and our knowledge with the family. If Agbon, some of us call him Agbon, if Agbon was here today, he would be saying to you, why are you all so gloomy? I mean, he was a funny, jovial man. Okay, but he dances, he's a humorist. So, Reverend, I leave the rest of the service to you, and I'm grateful that you enabled us to indulge ourselves this evening.
You will be indulging yourself very soon. Because we'll be drawing the service to a close shortly after these formalities. So you still have time because of the way it's been booked. That's why I try to time the service anyway. So you'll be indulging yourself. And then One of my colleagues is here, Sofo. May I invite you on the spot to lead us just in a prayer, please? Prayer of intercession, pray for the family as best as you just can. Maggie will be preparing the undertakers.
After all that we have heard, all that we have seen, and all the joys have shared our remembrance of Dumega, it is now the time that we have to come before God and commit ourselves to Him and give all our burdens and loads that we share, and especially the bereaved family, a difficult time and they need only the hand of God to keep, to bless, and to give peace to their sorrowing hearts. Therefore, I would like all of you to join me in prayer. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to you tonight for gathering here in you, in our presence, not for joy. Because we human beings have a different mind about death. But to you, death takes a different meaning altogether. To you, we come to you through death in your kingdom to be with you. But to us, it gives us sorrow. We have lost a loved one. A man who had shared his life with all of us. A man who has made those who are sad to be happy. A man who has shared his many gifts. And so when we miss him, we are very sorry. Our hopes are dashed. But Lord, coming to you, it's joy. And therefore, we want to pray for the bereaved family. You are the only one, God, who can give comfort to our sorrowing hearts. You are the only one who can speak your word of hope renewed in Christ Jesus. You are the only one, Lord, in times that the burden becomes too heavy for us. We hear your voice that saying that, cast all your burdens unto me, for I care for you. And Lord God Almighty, that is what we are doing tonight. We cast all the burdens of the family to you. A time of tears, a time of sadness. And we pray, Lord, that in your goodness, you wipe away all their tears. A time of hopelessness. We pray that in this situation, Lord, your word of comfort and peace be spoken into their hearts. Lord, bring joy and peace as they look up to you for your help. We thank you also for all the friends and those who related to him and all the testimonies that we have heard tonight, the tributes, Lord, and we pray that you reach out to all of us who knew Dumega Maxwell and bless all of us. And above all, tonight, God, help us with your message that you have sent to us tonight, that we shall live here with our minds centered on that. The letter that we are writing, when we present them to you, Lord, will you read them with joy and appreciation and to say, well done, good and faithful servants. Come to my right hand and rest, for you have been faithful in the little, but I will make you be responsible for much. And so, let our minds and hearts listen to you always, so that, God, we can give you a good account. And for the rest of these days, God, when at home we pray that, Lord, everything Lord, you lead them to send Dumega home peacefully. We pray that there will be no mishap anywhere. We pray against anything that will cause trouble and distinction between the family or anywhere. And we pray that, Lord Jesus, you spoke to us today. My peace I give to you. And this is what I pray for, Lord. Let your peace be in all the celebration until we send Dumega to you. Provide for them in their needs. And let all be done to the glory and the praise of your mighty name. We ask all this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. We will remain seated in our contemplatory mood. The casket will be opened. I will be commending Dumega on all our behalf as we join in to God. Then we'll be drawing the service to a close. Then we will have the time to file pass and pay our respects. When that is done, then the MC will take over. And then you continue to indulge yourself. Future for everyone. It is the last post of this life and the reveal of the next. Death is the end of our present life. It is the parting of from loved ones. We overcome death by accepting it as the will of a living God, by finding Him in it. Death, like birth, is only a transformation, another birth. When we die, we shall change our state, that is all. And with faith in God, it is as easy and natural as going to sleep here and waking up there. Surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses who have died in the faith of Christ and with whom we lift up our hearts to God, we now commend Dumega
Maxwell, Osimhen's Gbormittah to God's eternal care and keeping. Those of us gathered here in London, as not many of us will be able to go with him to Ghana next week when the funeral takes place. O God, who gives us life and in whose arms we die, we entrust Dumega, Maxwell, Koshi, Besah to your safekeeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Receive one of your own, one in whom you have been at work, who carries with him our love. Welcome him into your presence, into the rest of everlasting peace, and into the company of all the saints. Dumega, Maxwell, Koshi Besah, Gbormittah, Re, Makanye Kekeli Nao Nengkeke Me Azo, Ey Jinu Maga Dinao Bekeke Me Nako. The sun will no more be your light by day, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you. Kebo Yehoa Anye Wokekeli Tebe, Ewo Mau Anye Wachio Dodo. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Wo Maga Do Toasongo, Ewo Jinu Maga Doho. La bena yo ho ala nye wo keke li tebe. E wo nuha yi nuva yi. Your sun will never set again. And your moon will wane no more. The Lord will be your everlasting light. And your days of sorrow will end. Edenye Dumega, fare you well. Go on this journey in the name of God, the Father who created you. In the name of God, the Son who redeemed you. In the name of God, the Holy Spirit who sanctify you. In the company of angels and archangels and all the hosts of heaven, may your dwelling place be in heavenly Jerusalem. May your portion be peace. Amen. Keep standing, we sing, sleep on, beloved, sleep, and take your rest. It is on page 20, page 20 of the programs. Good night.
thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And the fifth hymn is, Guide me, O thou great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land. Page 21. Majesty, power, and authority before all time, and now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
As we go our separate ways, after viewing, and then the time is spent that we are allowed to stay here, may the Lord support us by His grace through all the hours of life's day. Until the shadows lengthen, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and the evening comes, then may the Lord, in His mercy, grant us safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last. May the God of hope fill you all with joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. And the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, guard your hearts and thoughts in Christ Jesus. Mutifafa maulan to na ko biauti kankan wa jana ko bobo ya pa luvo na pe mutina bi mo kata lo mo kaka de ke manowi ala se bi apeto yesu kristo pe baba gbela e to mutifafa le ga sabade mi aji du amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Is that good?
Thank you very
much. Now we'll view there. Just you have been very material.
Thank you very much, Reverend Dzandu-Hedidor. Dzandu-Hedidor. We are very grateful. We have now reached the point where those who wish to are invited to pay their last respects to the late Dumega. And I want us to start from the back, and are the undertakers going to help us indicate which row is coming through?
Okay, so
come through the back, through the center, and then go the sideways. So we, okay, Reverend is directed. Yes, you come through here, and you go through the other side back to your seat. And those who are also going to view from this side, you do the same, but you return to your seats. So without much ado, DJ, if you can give us some solemn hymn while we start the...
Because this is one of my expertise, sorry, Mr. Golegwe. From the back, through the center aisle, your left, you look at, view the body, through that side, back into your seat. So you just follow each other. Follow that way. By the time you are aware, you are all done that way. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I knew you would do that. So can we start, please? And the family will be the last to view the body.
Thank you. No alcohol are permitted on the premises.
And if you feel very strongly about this, and you wish to lodge your complaint or comments to the company, after all, companies exist to serve customers. So we as customers, if you feel you need to register your complaint, see Maggie will direct you to the undertaker's representative here.
Much has been said about him, and I'm not going to repeat that. But to the family, what we are saying is that when you meet Ghana and your back, let us know. But for now, on behalf of AUK, we are pledging £2,500 for you to assist with the expenses that you may obtain in the area of our patron, Mr. Dumega. So that's all I'm here to say.
Did you give KUK? Each concern, KUK, a big hand of applause. And Mwamanya won, I'm unaware, Yandakte, so thank you all very much. HUK. You can tell that I'm in a care business, so every time I hear about HUK, I think about the elderly, but not retired. Army officers and police officers, so do forgive me. We are going to retire. We've got time. We are booked from 6:30 to 10 o'clock. Maggie and the rest of the gang, the team, have put together that refreshment for us.
Video
to do in memory of. And so, in an orderly way, if no one has anything to say, or in memory of Gbon, I would want to, on behalf of the family, thank you very much. He was a very dear friend of my wife and I, and I recall in 1991, as I asked him to transport my golf bag. To Ghana. When I got to Ghana, I went to see the wife and we went to Accra Airport to collect a consignment. when my golf bag came out from the container, it looked much bigger than I remember giving to Elmo. When we opened the golf bag, it was packed to the brim with sardine, combi. So I said to the wife, I said, "Look, my golf bag didn't contain all this." When I gave them the bag to Elmo, and the wife said, "Well, that's a bomb for you." He never wasted space, and he used space. And he didn't charge me anything for taking the golf bag to a ground. I mean, when I think about him, I think about Frank. Well, it's Frank. And when I listen to the tributes, and I listen to all the things people said about him, I said, "Oh, I mean, there are sides of a boy that even his children didn't know. He was a jolly, jolly guy. Okay. I mean, he was also a mimic. I remember we went to the High Commission once when we had a chap called Odo, who was a deputy High Commissioner. And the boy was mimicking Mr. Odo in a proper way, not knowing what Mr. Bodo was standing by the door. and Mr. Bodo said, "You better move here and take the, and do the job, because you do it very well." He was a funny man. He had a profound sense of humor. I mean, when he's eating, he's singing. When he's dancing, he's singing. I mean, he was a life embodiment of fun. So I just one word to define a man. He was a man of fun. And I also describe him as having what I call the five F's. He was always focused. Always focused. He was always fast. So if you ask someone to do something for you, he'll say, "I'll do it on Friday." But he will surprise you by doing it on Wednesday. He was very fast. He was very friendly. He always had a smile on his face. When his health began to dwindle, he had a storage place on the 406 towards Edmonton, and I collected some books, and he was housing them in that place. So I went to his house and we tossed around, and we went there, and I said, "But what are you going to do for all these things?" He said, "They'll all get to that before I die." Yeah. That's the man he was. He was friendly. And the fourth F was that he was flexible. That was no problem. "Oh, we'll sort it out, don't worry." It was very, very flexible. And the fifth F is that he was fun. He was a bundle of fun. And so please let us, in our memory of him, pray to God that the sun continues to shine on his face, that the wind is always behind him, that the rain falls gently on his grave, and that may his soul rest in eternal peace and rise in glory, because that's what the Lord deserves, and he must have it. So I invite you all to have a drink before you make your journeys back to the destinations. And on Wednesday at 11 o'clock, whatever you're doing, just stop for a minute. And remember, I'm born. This was his last day. Going back to his makers. Thank you all very much. There is also a Rafa just reminded me, on the seats where you had the program, we also have donation envelopes. A poor, a gout with a warning. Funerals cost money, particularly in Ghana. They say, hey, if you feel fear, Rujaba. Okay, which means it costs money. So any little donation you can give to the family will be very highly appreciated. Nothing is too much or too little. Your support in the form of money, cash. Cash has become a very dirty word, but nonetheless, it is still in use. It's a legal tender or a check. Make sure there is money behind to support the thing. I remember once my children and I and my wife were traveling, and we got to a place in Saint-Tropez. And this is about 2 o'clock in the morning. And I went to a filling station to fill the car, and then realized that I didn't have money. So I went into the car and said to my wife, and have you got any money on you? And my daughter, who was now 4 years old, is now 40, said, Dad, you mean you brought us all this way without money? So as we take our boss remains back to Accra and Anyapo, the family will need the necessary resources, and your help will be appreciated. So I thank you in advance for all you're about to do. Thank you. I invite you now to have a glass of water or a Fanta or Coca-Cola for you. Thank you.